Secondly, like, as you're getting into this role and so on, you've been, you know, I'm sure you know, Jeff Johns, people like that, it's giving you a ton of things that you've done. So what have you loved about discovering this character both in the show as well as in the comics?
Well, what I love about Tara is that she is still, she's in this process of discovering herself. And this really is, like, I look at it as a coming of age story. I love when she finds her strength, when she owns it. That is my favorite, those are my favorite parts to play. She has no fear.
Yeah, I'm sure you did a ton of research on this. You know, maybe read a lot of the comics, maybe saw a lot of the animated series. What were some of your favorite stories you remember of that you've been in the past?
I'm trying to think. Well, I read a lot of the New 52. I don't know.
What is he like about the character?
I think there's like this. I think that she has this lovely naivety a little bit, you know? I love that she has a knowledge of where she comes from and has. I think her history is so sad that she knew. I mean, Kal-El had no idea what his planet or what his parents were like, and she has it very clear that she grew up. And I think that's a really beautiful, sad story. Really.
Sarah was talking a lot about accessibility and relatability for teenage girls and what Supergirl is doing for feminism. Can you talk a little bit about how this is really just how it's also a story just about identity and finding yourself and being okay with your power as a woman?
Oh yeah. Well, I mean, I'm sort of going through it on my own right now. You know, I don't think you're ever done learning about yourself, especially as women. We're complicated. Like multifaceted creatures and very flawed, and that's what I love about. That's another thing I love about Kara, is that she is constantly messing up, and she doesn't really know. She's kind of flying by the seat of her pants half the time, as in our pilot, with what we've done so far. And I just love that. I love that there's room to grow, and that it shows that. No one ever has it all figured out, no matter how many powers you have, you know? And it's funny, I knew that this was going to be a facet of it, to be a role model for young girls, that the crew members would be bringing their daughters on set. And until I saw them in person when I was in the suit, I didn't realize what it was going to feel like, and that was powerful.
You're doing amazing things for this audience, for this demographic.
Yes.
How did it feel putting on this
suit? I felt like I was on top of the world the first time I put it on. It's impossible not to feel this internal shift of just like strength and bravery. It makes me feel brave.
When you were growing up, were you a lot into, were you a big fan of comic books, comic movies and stuff like that?
I watched the movies more. I wasn't much of a comic book reader when I was younger. Until college, my closest friend is a huge comic book reader and graphic novels. So I kind of read some of them when I was in college. But I loved Michael Keaton as Batman. I grew up on those movies.
TV shows?
Definitely a sci-fi fan in general.
Any TV shows you like that? In the superhero genre? Like.
I liked Lois and Lois. Yeah.
And now he's your dad.
I know. He's so nice, too.
Yeah.
He's such a nice guy.
Yeah.
How important is it for you to be able to play a female superhero that young women can look up to?
I look at it as such a privilege and a responsibility to just be, to show people that you can be, have strength and be a strong woman without people. I think so much, so often these days, it's kind of assumed that if you're strong and powerful, you're not really the nicest person, or maybe you know, B-I-T-C-H or what have you, but this, I want to show girls that you can spread positivity and hope through your strength, and